Did I? Yeah, John Bryden, you're wearing a yes button. What do you feel about the result?
Well, obviously I'm disappointed, but I think the fact is that 45% of Scots people voted for a separation from England, and I don't think that can be ignored by the politicians. It's quite clear, as Sarah says, that this is about democracy. It's not about oil. This is about representation. It's about moving from a Westminster system, which is completely out of date, to something which is more like the rest of democratic Europe, and particularly Norway. And I don't think people outside have understood that, and I don't think people inside the country have addressed that, you know, until the last minute, when we start to see people saying, oh, well, maybe Westminster needs to be reformed, and so on and so forth, which is, I hope, going to happen now as a result of this vote.
So, despite the result, are you hopeful for Scotland's future?
Well, I'm always hopeful, of course. I'm always optimistic. But I think it will be far better if they can get far more devolution, also of fiscal powers and of resources to Scotland, and indeed to the rest of the constituent parts of the UK, and that Westminster is given a much lesser role in the future.
And a last question, how has it been watching the campaign from Norway?
Well, I think it's been very exciting. It's been a tremendous campaign. I think the Yes campaign has done a tremendous job in persuading the no vote, the undecided, to vote yes. I mean, when you think back at the 30% or so of people who said they would vote yes at the beginning of the campaign, I think it's a tremendous job they've done. I think the fact that 98% of the eligible electorate signed up to vote is also incredible in Scotland, when you think that only 20 or 30% vote in local government elections, and about half vote in European elections. I mean, it's really extraordinary. Strike for democracy.
Så selv om man kanskje litt misfornøyd med resultatet, så man veldig håpefulle for Skottlands fremtid.